Greetings, my affectionate children. This video is specially for class 11th and 12th because in their writing section, it will be a part of writing section in the letters, job application and resume. Okay, so in this video, I will just teach you job application, how to write a job application, what is resume, what is biodata, and what do you mean by CV. So what do you mean by job application? Means job application you have to write in that case when you want to apply in any business, in any school or in any company or somewhere else where you want to get a job. So this is the application for applying the job. Second is, with this application, you have to submit your resume also. You have to attach your biodata or your CV also. Okay. So what do you mean by CV there? CV is their curriculum vitae. CV means here curriculum vitae. Curriculum vitae means, this is a Latin word and it means course of life. What do you mean by curriculum vitae? Curriculum vitae means, this is a Latin word and it means course of life. Means in this you will write whatever you have done in your life. Second is resume word. Resume is a French word and it means also summary. Summary means a summary of your life, whatever you have done in your life. Okay, and biodata. Biodata again, a format or a list of your education and work experience. So means to say the meaning of all these three. All these three, like resume, biodata, and curriculum vitae, all have the same meaning, that whatever you have done in your career, you have to just write your experience about your education also. Okay, so let's come to the video there. How will we start to write job application? The very first is given there. How many types of letters are there in 11th and 12th class especially? There are five types of letters. How many types? Five types of letters are there. First is a complaint letter. Complaint letter means if you have a complaint about the toilet lost or cycle lost, or complaint of defective items like refrigerator, okay, or complain about iron, defective iron, so you can write about that also. Second is your job application and resume. That is there for the post of CA, clerk, accountant, sales manager, receptionist, or teacher, etc. So there will be job application and resume about these topics. These are very, very famous topic for the board classes there, right? Next is letter to editor. That is very, very common. Everybody knows that we always draw the public attention towards some special or some social, some common issues there, right? Next is their place and order letter. Place and order there means if we are placing some order, sometime we are canceling the order, sometime we are just a reply of the order also there. Okay, so such kind of topics are there. And next is their inquiry letter. Inquiry letter is means planning for the trip or some course, to join some course. So all these are the types of letters for 11th and 12th class especially. Okay, now this is the format, that how will you get the marks there in this one. So this is the format, this is the marking scheme of all kinds of letter which you have to give there in class 10th, 11th and 12th. Okay, in 10th also letters are there, 11th and 12th job application and resume, but in 10th class job application resume is not there. So this format is there for 10th, 11th, 12th class, and how the marking will be there according to 10th class. The format will be of 1 mark, but in 11th and 12th class, format will remain of same 1 mark, right? In content, it will be of 4 mark, but in 11th and 12th, content will be of 2 marks. Accuracy, 1.5 mark, but in 11th and 12th, accuracy will be of 1 mark. And fluency, 1.5 mark for 10th class, but 1 mark for 11th and 12th class. Why this is there? Because in 11th and 12th class, the letter will be in 6 marks, and in 10 marks, it will be of 8 marks. Okay, so like this, it will be there divide, and like this, it will be checked there in the board examination. Next is there, what is the format of writing job application? You know, job application consists of two parts there. One is there, you have to write application. Second will be biodata, CV or resume. So what is there? First of all, you know, all the letters format is, will remain same. Like first of all, sender address you have to write left side, then date you have to write after one line gap, then after one line gap you have to write receiver's address, right? After one line gap you have to write a subject there, and after that you have to write a salutation. Salutation means you are going to give regard or greet to some person like a sir or ma'am. This salutation you have to write. After that one line gap you have to write body of the letter there. Like in the body of the letter, you have to divide this body into three parts: para first, para second, para third. So in para first, you will introduce about what you want to write there, like which date, which day, which advertisement you have seen, on the behalf of which you want to apply somewhere in the company. Okay, and next will be paragraph two. You have to write there that how you are claiming that you are good experienced person and good qualified person, that you are applicable for that particular post. And the third paragraph, in third paragraph, you will enclose your paragraph by saying that you will be waiting for the positive response there, right? And after writing all three paragraphs, you have to write a complimentary clause like yours faithfully, otherwise yours sincerely, otherwise yours truly, you have to write there. And yes, specially pay attention towards this yours word. You will write yours without apostrophe sign. Means yours, you will write without apostrophe sign, faithfully. Okay. And after that, sincerely also see yours like this. You will write, no student will write apostrophe sign there. Okay. Next is their signature you have to do there. Okay. And one more thing, everybody has to write your that name, which is given in the question paper. If you will write your personal name, that marks will deduct there surely. Right. And the second part of biodata is there that in biodata, what will you write there? You have to write every detail of yours, like photograph you have to paste. After that, you have to write whatever you have done in your career. And after that, you have to write the copies of certificates also there. You have to attest there. And another information there, that also you have to attest with your job application. Okay. Next is their biodata. What you have to write? Personal detail you have to write. Then qualification you have to write. After that, experience you have to write. And then reference means so on whose reference you are going to apply in this company or in this school or in this business. Means reference means that person on the behalf of whose you want to get job on in the same branch there, in the same school or in the same business. Okay, now come to the question, how to write this application. So question is given to you, Bal Vidya Public School Bhilai urgently requires a postgraduate teacher to teach political science. Means political science subject ke liye ab aapko kya hai, postgraduate teacher chahiye yahan par. Kaun se school ke liye? Bal Vidya. Kaun se school hai yahan par? Bal Vidya Public School. For that school you have to write application. You are going to apply for the post of a political science teacher. As a PGT political science teacher, you are going to apply there in this school. Okay, and you have seen this advertisement in Bhilai Express newspaper. So you are Sanjay or Sanjana. You have to write either Sanjay or Sanjana name. Okay, your address is given 21 Vasant Marg, Bhilai. This is your address given there. And draft a letter including a CV applying for the advertised post. Jo advertise ki gayi hai post, usi post ke behalf pe, usi advertisement ke behalf pe, sabse pehle aap kya karte ho? Advertisement dekhte ho. Us advertisement ko dekhne ke baad, aap kya karte ho? Yahan par apply karte ho. Okay, so same will happen there. You have to first write your own address. You know, sender address. Who is sender? You are the sender. So what is your address? 21 Vasant Marg, Bhilai. Here you can write your address in two lines or three lines. Okay, next one line gap you have to take, then current date you have to write. No one will write date word there. Okay, this is the main and common mistake of most of the students. They always write date word, but no need to write date. You have to write a direct date there. What is the date? Like 22 April 2020, whatever is there. Next is there one line gap, then the principal, because you are applying there in a school, and for the school the principal will be there. Then Bal Vidya Public School is given to you already, and Bhilai is also given. After that, one line gap, then you have to write a subject. And what is the subject? Application for the post of postgraduate teacher or postgraduate pole science teacher. So you have to write their complete application for the post of after that you have to write whatever the post you are applying, like application for the post of English teacher, application for the post of primary teacher, application for the post of CA, for the color. So like this, you have to just change last word and rest will remain same. Next is there, you will write a salutation like sir or ma'am. After that, what will you write? The starting line will always be there, in response to your advertisement. Means ye jo aap letter likh rahe ho, kiske response mein likh rahe ho? Us advertisement ke response mein likh rahe ho, jo ki apne आपने भिलाई एक्सप्रेस में देखी थी वो एडवर्टाइजमेंट, और किस डेट को देखी थी आपने लिख दिया मार्च अप्रैल 20 और 22 जो भी था आपका, आपने डेट डाल दी लेटर लिखने से एक या दो दिन पहले की आपको डेट यहाँ पे डालनी है फॉर द पोस्ट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल साइंस। पॉलिटिकल साइंस के लिए आपने इसको यहाँ पर देखा, यहाँ पे आपने एडवर्टाइजमेंट और उसी के बिहाफ पे यहाँ पर अप्लाई कर रहे हो, ठीक है। टीचर इन योर रिन्यूड स्कूल, आपका जो स्कूल है, आपका जो रेपुटेड स्कूल है, इस स्कूल में मैंने जो है वो एडवर्टाइजमेंट देखी थी न्यूज पेपर में, भिलाई एक्सप्रेस में, और उसी के बिहाफ पे मैं आपके स्कूल में अप्लाई करना चाहता हूँ। आई विश टू ऑफर माई कैंडिडेचर, मैं अपनी कैंडिडेचर को ऑफर करना चाहती हूँ आपके स्कूल के लिए। आई एम अवेलेबल फॉर द इंटरव्यू ऑन द डे ऑफ योर कन्वीनियंस, मीन जब आप चाहोगे तो मैं इंटरव्यू के लिए यहाँ पर एप्लीकेबल हो जाऊंगी, अवेलेबल हो जाऊंगी। इफ गिवन अ चांस टू सर्व यू, अगर आपने मुझे चांस दिया सर्विस करने का, आई एश्योर यू दैट आई शैल वर्क विद सिंसियरिटी एंड डेडिकेशन अप टू योर सेटिस्फेक्शन, जितनी आपकी सेटिस्फेक्शन हो सकेगी मैं अपनी आपको सेटिस्फाई करने की पूरी कोशिश करूंगी। I'm enclosing a copy of my biodata for your personal and kind consideration. Thank you. After consideration, you will take one line gap. Thank you. After thank you, again take one line gap. Then yours faithfully, Sanjay Sanjana, any one name, and after that enclosed your biodata. So these lines will always remain same. आप हमेशा एक बात पे focus करना बेटा। आपके लिए चाहे वो post CA की है, चाहे वो post आपकी clerk के लिए, चाहे manager के लिए है, ठीक है, चाहे वो आपकी फिर chartered accountant के लिए या फिर आपकी post graduation के लिए primary teacher के लिए, ध्यान रखना। आप just ये देखना कि कौन से न्यूज़पेपर में आपने उस ऐड को देखा, तो जस्ट उस पेपर का नेम चेंज कर दो और डेट देख लो, जिस डेट को आपको बोला ना, किस डेट को आपने लिखा है, तो उसे एक या दो दिन पहले की डेट डाल दो यहाँ पे, पहले की डेट यहाँ पे आएगी क्योंकि आप पहले आप एडवर्टाइजमेंट देखते हो। उसके बाद देखो आपको कुछ भी चेंज नहीं करना इसमें, फॉर द पोस्ट ऑफ पोस्ट के बाद जो पोस्ट दी है उसका नेम यहाँ पे डाल दो, ठीक है। उसके बाद आई विश ये कैंडिडेचर, ये बिल्कुल सेम रहेगी हर एक पोस्ट के लिए, आगे सारी बिल्कुल सेम रहेंगी, आपको कुछ भी चेंज नहीं करना। ये मैंने वो लाइंस आपको दी है जिसमें आपको कुछ भी चेंज करने की जरूरत नहीं है। आपको जस्ट यहाँ पे क्या करना है, जस्ट आपने न्यूज़पेपर देखना कि कौन से न्यूज़पेपर में आपने एडवर्टाइजमेंट देखी है। अगर उसने न्यूज़पेपर दे रखा है तो लिखो, अगर नहीं दे रखा तो आप एज इट इज यही वाला भी लिख सकते हो, ठीक है। इसके बाद आपने लिखना है फॉर द पोस्ट ऑफ, जस्ट आपको यहाँ चेंज करना है कौन सी पोस्ट के लिए आप यहाँ पर अप्लाई कर रहे हो, दैट्स ऑल। आपको जस्ट ये टू थिंग्स आपने चेंज करनी है, बाकी एज इट इज सारी लाइंस रहेंगे। अगर आप यहाँ पर एज इट इज लाइन करना चाहो तो एज इट इज आप कर सकते हो for any of the posts, okay? So I gave you best lines there. After that, biodata. Biodata में क्या होता है? One side you have to paste your photograph. Like यहाँ पे आप अपनी photograph paste कर सकते हो। उसके बाद biodata में सबसे पहले अपन name लिखेंगे अपना, father name, date of birth, address, phone number, email, okay? Marital status, age, nationality. After that, academic qualification. Hobbies, strength and reference. So what is given there? You will write everything there. And yes, pay attention this side, date of birth. Date of birth, कुछ student कैसे ले देते हैं अपनी actual date of birth यहाँ पे डालते हैं कि actual date of birth के according तो आप 11th या 10th class के according ही यहाँ पे show होगे, तो आपको अपनी age से 5-6 year back यहाँ पर date डालनी है, ध्यान रखना। अगर आप 10th 11th में तो आप किसी job के लिए applicable नहीं हो, आप नहीं apply कर सकते, तो आपको यहाँ पर अपनी actual date of birth डालने की बजाय क्या करना है, यू हैव टू राइट 6-7 ईयर्स बैक देयर, ओके। सो अगर आपकी डेट ऑफ बर्थ मान लो 90 की है तो आप यहां पर 84, 83, 82 डाल सकते हो यहां पर। अगर आपकी डेट ऑफ बर्थ मान लीजिए आ जाते 93 की है, 94 की, तो 84 डालो, 10 इयर्स बैक में चले जाओ ताकि आप अपना एक्सपीरियंस भी यहाँ पर दिखा सको। क्योंकि अगर आप यहाँ पर डेट ऑफ बर्थ डाल देते हो अपनी करंट, तो आप तो वहां पर उस टाइम पे 10th क्लास में ही शो होते हो, फिर आप एक्सपीरियंस यहाँ पर नहीं लिख पाओगे, फिर आप अपनी MA BA भी नहीं लिख पाओगे क्योंकि आप तो भी 10th क्लास में शो हो जाते हो। तो यहाँ पर आप 10 इयर्स बैक ले लो जो भी आपकी डेट ऑफ बर्थ है, डेट बेशक आप सेम रख लो, इसके बाद जो ईयर है उसको आप चेंज कर दो, 10 इयर्स पहले वाला डाल दो यहाँ पर, ठीक है। एड्रेस वट एवर इज रिटन देयर, वट एवर इज गिवन, सेम नेम यू हैव टू राइट, सेम ईमेल आईडी यू हैव टू मेक ऑन द सेम टाइम। आफ्टर दैट मैरिटल स्टेटस, यू आर सिंगल और मैरिड यू हैव टू राइट, एंड एज ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वन, वट इज यूर एज, 28 ईयर्स, राइट, अदरवाइज यूर एक्चुअल एज विल बी यू नो 15 और 16 ईयर्स इफ यू विल राइट यूर एक्चुअल डेट ऑफ बर्थ देयर। सो जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस डेट ऑफ बर्थ एंड दिस is there. After that you have to write like BA is in political science. Now keep it in mind, if you are applying for pol science, so qualification will be according to pol science, like BA in pol science, MA in pol science, and BEd for teaching line, right? Next is their hobbies. What are your hobbies? Like good communication skill, computer, okay, or proficiency in English, Hindi, or German, etc. Means you can write your extra strength there. And now the main important is reference. Reference means there, whose reference are you taking there? Like you have to write that person address whom you know where you are applying there. Means jis company mein aap yahan par job karne ja rahe ho, jis company ke liye aap apply karne ja rahe ho, us company mein kis person ko aap jante ho, us person ki designation kya hai. ठीक है, आप मान लो प्रिंसिपल को ही जानते हो तो प्रिंसिपल का ही नेम डाल दो वहां पर. तो मैनेजमेंट जब भी आपका इंटरव्यू लेगी तो ये सोचे कि यस प्रिंसिपल से केनोन में है, तो आपके इंटरव्यू में यहाँ पर आपको इजी रहेगा. फिर अगर आप ये है कि आप इस पर्सन को जानते हो यहाँ पे, तो उस पर्सन का नेम यहाँ पे डालो. मीन्स रेफरेंस में यह है कि आप किस फेमस पर्सनैलिटी को जानते हो, यू हैव टू राइट इन दैट. Okay, so it was your job application and resume. I taught you in every best way. I hope you will pause the video and note down this job application and resume there. Okay, you have to write all the key points, all the important things, the format also there, right? And if you want to watch my other videos, subscribe the channel so that whenever I will upload the video on the YouTube, then you will get the video on the same time. Thank you so much for watching the video. Have a nice day, everybody.